I think biology, in a way, you know, it's frightening, but I'm very sympathetic to this in many ways, that it would be nice to get a more water-efficient plant, but still, it would still need water. Craig Venter cannot create a plant which needs no water and no nitrogen, or which totally fixes all its nitrogen by sucking it from the air. You know, it's just, it cannot go that far. This doesn't fundamentally change the game. What fundamentally changes the game, and what people don't want to hear, and I'm coming across all the time, and people say, you know, don't talk to us like that because this is a no starter. But for me, this is the only starter. We have to use less. The poor people need more. There is no doubt about it. There is no discussion there. Right? If you are average villager somewhere in Rajasthan or Punjab or Nigeria, you need more, period. There's a basic human decency compels you to say these people need more, more clean water, more basic food, more education for their children. The discussion closed, right, before it begins, right? But as far as us is concerned, we certainly could and should do with much, much, much less. People have been conditioned that things have to always get go better. And immediately as you say, limit something, people think this is not getting better. But it would be. It's even a non-starter saying people, you should eat less. You should eat less meat, right? That's a non-starter, right? You should use less electricity, right? You should build smaller cars. The other day I saw the vice president of GM talking about the new GM, right? And one of these journalists asked him rightly, you know, but your cars are still so heavy. And he says, yes, we are working on it. What is there to work on it, right? There are so many things which we could do, you know, not to surrender our standard of living, not to kind of live in a gutter, really, right? You know, but we don't need 1.5-ton car to go from red light to red light in a city, really, right? People are not willing to go back on these things. Most of them simply are not, because they've been totally hijacked by this material culture. Let's not underestimate the persuasion, the power of this material culture is immense. It's just immense. When I've seen so many people being so genuinely unhappy that they cannot afford a 50,000 square foot, oh, sorry, $50,000 bathroom remodeling, right? I mean, there's something wrong with that value set, right? You know, because bathroom is a place where you should spend like, whatever, 10 minutes to take your shower, brush your teeth, right? So it doesn't have to be worse. But you know how much money people are, so, again, on my mind, because we are thinking about redoing our bathroom, right? So it's on my mind, so it's very interesting. So for me, it's a chore because it has to be done, right? But for many people, it's kind of a life-affirming thing, you know? People are renting storage spaces, right, which they will never access in the next 20 years to store the junk which they cannot store in their 5,000 square foot homes, right? So do we need that, really? So it's just amazing. So it's this is very difficult to put the genie in the bottle. So everything is defined in this material thing. I could make it a lot more coherent, but you see, this is difficult because when you make it a lot more coherent, you make it prescriptive. And prescriptions never work, really, because I don't have the solution. I can't sit here and say, you know, we should follow this, and by 2030, everything click, and we all live happily ever after, right? You know, so I'm making it deliberately uncoherent. I could be, you know, I could be very doctrinaire. But you see, I live for 26 years in a communist society. I'm inoculated against any doctrinaire grand solution saying, you know, this is the pattern, this is the master, this is the paradigm which you have to follow, you know. I'm just totally set against it. So I'm making things deliberately kind of, you know, messy, incoherent, uncoordinated, because that's how life is. We don't know what pattern will emerge. As long as we are living amidst of this sea of affluence and opportunities and material riches, it's just very difficult to make this individual, voluntary, resolute step and saying enough, back, limit. Very difficult.
Acho que chegamos à era dos limites. Ainda que sejamos livres, nós somos livres para viver de acordo com a natureza que fomos criados.